Hello YouTube. Today we're talking about pressure switches that are used on water well pumps and the reasons why they fail. I'm going to start this by saying that pressure switches are an extremely reliable device, and usually they only fail if they've got something else that causes them to. One of the more common problems is when the pressure tank gets waterlogged or overinflated. Either one of these will cause the points to open and close rapidly, fast cycling. That fast cycling will increase the wear on the points to the point of failure. Typically, when we see failure is when it gets down to about a 10-second cycle time or less. We've had switches turning on every second or two, just click, 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 click. So that's extremely hard on switches, pumps, everything else. I've got an example of that here. One of the things you'll see is the inside of the box gets all smoked up. Another thing you'll notice looking at the points is they get burned and blackened. Occasionally they will fuse together where the pump won't shut off, and that's actually what happened to this switch. More often, they get to where they won't contact and the pump won't start. The pressure switch also needs to be mounted close to where the pressure tank is. If you get it mounted too far away, the line bounce when the pump turns on and off will sit there and click the switch in and out, fast cycling it as well. It might bounce a couple times, it might continue to bounce until it burns itself out every time the pump turns on. One thing you can do to correct that is to, if you do need to remote mount a switch, take a separate line from right next to the tank where you'd normally mount the switch and run a dedicated line up to the switch. Doing that, you can mount the switch basically however far away you want. You can go clear across the house or further if need be. Another problem we run into is when people try to change out a switch and they don't match the switch to the tank or match the tank to the switch after they get done. The tank and the switch need to be adjusted together to work properly. That's not an issue with air charge tanks, but it is an issue with captive air tanks. The tank needs to be set a couple pounds under the cut-in pressure on the switch. If you put too much air into the tank, then it's not going to let any water into it, and it's just as bad, if not worse, than having not enough air in the tank. Another thing that we see quite often is you get ants or spiders in the pressure switch. You can barely make it out, but there's a little black ant up in that corner. Another one on the bottom side. That's just enough to keep that switch from contacting. Along with ants in the switch, we also have a whole bunch of small spiders around here, and they've been known to get in the switch too. You can see the spider web in the bottom, and actually there is a little spider in the top, but this switch here was actually still operational until the time the pump was pulled. It'd probably been in there for close to 20 years. So, not really in that bad a shape for what it is. Along with ants and spiders, even just the dirt blowing can put enough dirt into the points to not work sometimes. Another thing, snow. Whenever you get a blizzard, you can have snow blow up into the points and it does not conduct electricity well. So it can keep it from turning on. Another thing that can happen is the nipple on the bottom of the switch, especially if it's made out of a steel nipple, they tend to plug up and the pump will either stay on or off, and sometimes you'll have extremely high pressure because the switch has an extremely delayed reaction to whether the pump's running or not. And then when the pump is supposed to cut in, it won't cut in on time, so the pressure will go off for a while. So if it's low pressure, high pressure, low pressure, high pressure, more than likely there's a restriction in the nipple underneath. For us, when we put our switches in, we'll put a brass nipple under there, and that seems to take care of it. You'll still get a little bit of corrosion around the inside of the steel on the bottom of the switch, but it doesn't tend to plug up near as often as having a steel nipple underneath it. Another thing I wanted to go over was selecting the proper switch. One of the failures we have is if you take a 3050 switch and try to turn it up too far, it won't be able to operate properly once you get past about 70, 75 pounds. If you try to turn it up to 80 or 100, it's not going to happen. Some places sell the pressure switches with the lever on the side. Makes them easy to turn on and off. Other ones with the lever on the side, wrote on the side here, have an auto start off position. That's not the kind of switch you want to have on a well pump because it will not reset itself after it gets down below about 20 pounds. So if you turn on too much water or if the power goes out for a little bit and your water pressure drops, you'll have to go down and physically hold the points together until it gets enough pressure buildup to keep itself running. This is a big nuisance trip, and it just does not protect the pump the way you want it to in a water well situation. They were designed for pumping out of a tank or a cistern, where when the water's out, you want the pump to stay off. But in a well, it recovers by itself, so you want the pump to be able to come back on by itself too.
The one with the auto position in it is this one here. And you'll notice you have to lift up on the lever a little bit to get the points to contact. Have to hold it in to get it to start. And then it has the off position in it as well. But when there's no pressure on it, it will not start to pump. The ones that are just an on-off position here, they'll start the pump by themselves, and then you have the option to physically turn the pump off just with the lever. But they will sit there and operate normally under the pressure load.
Other things we get into, if you're on a pressure system with an air charge tank, you have to make sure that the gasket around the bottom of this is not leaking any. When we see this most is when it gets extremely cold, well below freezing. Sometimes I think the steel and the rubber contract at a different rate when it gets cold, and they'll start seeping air when they've worked fine the rest of the year. That'll bleed all the air out of your tank, and then you've got a waterlogged tank. Another thing, when it's below freezing outside and you're on an air charge system with this mounted above ground, if you're mounted like this, any condensation that builds up on the inside of this can drain out. If you're mounted sideways, any condensation can get trapped in the bottom of this and cause it to not turn on. Another failure that can happen with an air charge style tank is the air chargers themselves can quit working. Typically they've got two weeper valves in the well and then a check valve above them. If the check valve on top fails, what you'll see is when you go out there, the tank is probably completely empty. When the pressure comes off, the air chargers go ahead and drain down. So if you have an air charge system where the tank is drained down when you get there and you think everything's working but you're not sure, that's a good place to start is that check valve. Another thing that can happen is if your wires aren't done properly, they can rub up against the side of the switch where it comes through here. Sometimes that's a little sharp, and it can short up against the side and cause a failure that way. That's not any fault of the switch, it just is a failure due to improper installation. Another failure that is possible is if your pressure switch is mounted someplace where it can get flooded, the water can get inside and cause extremely rapid corrosion of all the internal components. Water and electricity do not get along together. I've got another example of a switch here that I'll show you.
This particular switch is mounted on a check valve and male adapters, and the male adapter on the pump side was cracked, where whenever the pump was running, it was getting sprayed with water. The water spray did most of the damage, and then actually got covered up in black ants too, so it had more than one thing causing it to fail. Okay, that about covers it. One thing to take away from this video is if the pressure switch fails and you just replace the switch, that does not mean you fixed the problem. You just delayed it, and more than likely you're going to end up killing the pump or control box, which are both way more expensive than what this little switch is. So if you have a switch that fails, find out why.